The sea urchins are frequently used as animal models for developmental biology. The unfertilized sea urchin egg is a single spherical cell about 90 microns in diameter. Like any other cell, it contains nucleus and cytoplasm, but the cytoplasm is enriched with yolk, which could be used as an energy source until the embryo can feed on its own. The high yolk content gives the egg its yellow color. Another difference between the egg and any other cell is that it contains special cortical granules just below the plasma membrane. Also, there is a special vitelline layer that is initially attached to the plasma membrane. Remember the granules and the layer. You will see how they work in just about a minute. Importantly, the egg is haploid. The nucleus contains only one copy of every chromosome. In that case, after meeting haploid sperm, which also has only one copy of every chromosome, the resulting zygote is diploid and has a pair of every chromosome, one from a female and one from a male. If more than one sperm enters the egg, the process called polyspermy, too many chromosomes would be present in the embryo, which would lead to abnormal development and death. Let's see how the sea urchin egg can prevent this from happening. Right at this moment, I am adding the sperm to the eggs. A fast block is induced within 1 second after the fastest sperm enters the egg and persists about 60 seconds. This block is an electrical effect. There is a sudden change in the sodium ions in the egg that spreads over the membrane in an electrical wave of activity. This is not visible under the microscope. 20 seconds after the sperm enters, the slow block kicks in, and it has to deal with the cortical granules I told you about earlier. The sperm entry triggers the granules to release their content between the egg plasma membrane and the vitelline layer. One of the enzymes that is present in the granules changes the vitelline layer so that the sperm cannot attach to it anymore. Another enzyme breaks down the molecules that glue together the plasma membrane and the vitelline layer, which causes it to get released and balloon around the eggs, forming an additional protection. You can see on the video that the eggs are now surrounded by this balloon called fertilization envelope. All successfully fertilized eggs are now surrounded by it. In addition to blocking the entry of the second sperm, this envelope also helps to prevent physical damage by acting as a cushion. Let's review again how the fertilization envelope is formed. There are cortical granules inside the egg and the vitelline layer just outside of the egg. The sperm entry causes the granule next to the place of the entry to fuse to the plasma membrane and to release its content between the membrane and the vitelline layer. This triggers a chain reaction. More and more granules fuse with the plasma membrane, and the vitelline layer begins to bud over the membrane. This event spreads further and further until the vitelline layer balloons around the fertilized egg and the embryo begins to develop. Sea urchins are unique organisms that are very useful as an animal model for embryogenesis, and they just touch base one of the most fascinating processes, fertilization of the eggs. Please feel free to ask me any questions in the comments below this video, and I would be happy if you subscribe to my channel, where I will be uploading more and more videos about embryogenesis and science in general. Thank you very much for watching. Bye.